Welcome back. Did you know that Microsoft is one of the most successful tech companies in history? With a market capitalization of over $1 trillion. Hundreds of millions of people use Microsoft every day, and its logo is one of the most recognized in the world. As a matter of fact, Microsoft is one of the top 5 tech companies in the world. The others are Facebook, Apple, Amazon, and Google. In this video, we'll look at the history of Microsoft and its story so far. We'll analyze how it rose to become one of the top tech companies in the world. Stay with us and make sure you hit the like and bell button. Number 1. The origin. On April 4, 1975, at a time when most Americans used typewriters, childhood friends, Bill Gates and Paul Allen found Microsoft, a company that makes computer software. Originally based in Albuquerque, New Mexico, Microsoft relocated to Washington State in 1979 and eventually grew into a major multinational technology corporation. In 1987, the year after Microsoft went public, 31-year-old Gates became the world's youngest billionaire. Gates and Allen started Microsoft, originally called Microsoft, for microprocessors and software in order to produce software for the Altair 8800, an early personal computer. Allen quit his job as a programmer in Boston, while Gates left Harvard University, where he was a student, to focus on their new company. Microsoft at the time, based in Albuquerque because the city was home to electronics firm MITS, maker of the Altair 8800. By the end of 1978, Microsoft sales topped more than $1 million, and in 1979 the business moved its headquarters to Bellevue, Washington, a suburb of Seattle, where Gates and Allen grew up. The company went on to license its MS-DOS operating system to IBM for its first personal computer, which debuted in 1981. Afterward, other computer companies started licensing MS-DOS, which had no graphical interface and required users to type in commands to open a program. In 1983, Allen departed Microsoft due to Hodgkin's lymphoma. He was successfully treated for the disease, but he went on to pursue a variety of other business ventures. Number 2. History and growth. 1985 to 1994. Microsoft released Microsoft Windows on November 20, 1985, as a graphical extension for MS-DOS, despite having begun developing OS 2 with IBM the previous August. Then in 1986, Microsoft moved its headquarters from Bellevue to Redmond. In this same year, the company went public. The success meant that Gates became a billionaire at age 31. In 1990, Microsoft introduced the Microsoft Office suite, which bundled separate applications such as Microsoft Word and Microsoft Excel, which are still used today. On May 22, Microsoft launched Windows 3.0, featuring streamlined user interface graphics and improved protected mode capability for the Intel 386 processor, and both Office and Windows became dominant in their respective areas. 1995 to 2007. Microsoft released Windows 95, featuring preemptive multitasking, a completely new user interface with a novel start button, and 32-bit compatibility. Like NT, it provided the Win32 API. Windows 95 came bundled with the online service MSN, which was at first intended to be a competitor to the Internet and, for OEMs, Internet Explorer, a web browser. Less than a year after the formation of the Trusted Computing Platform Alliance in 1999 by a group of companies, which included Microsoft, Bill Gates handed over the CEO position to Steve Ballmer. Ballmer was an old college friend of Gates and employee of the company since 1980, while creating a new position for himself as chief software architect. On October 25, 2001, Microsoft released Windows XP, unifying the mainstream and NT lines of OS under the NT codebase. The company released the Xbox later that year, entering the video game console market already dominated by Sony and Nintendo. Between 2004 and 2005, due to an antitrust legal action brought against Microsoft by the European Union, the company started producing other versions of Windows OS. That was how Windows XP Home N and Windows XP Pro N came about. Xbox 360 was also released during that period. 2007 to 2011. In January 2007, Microsoft released the Windows Vista. It focused on features, security, and a redesigned user interface dubbed Aero. Microsoft Office 2007 was also released that year. In 2008, co-founder Bill Gates retired from his role as chief software architect, a decision which had been announced earlier. And the following year, Microsoft announced its intent to open a chain of Microsoft-branded retail stores. Still in 2009, the same day Microsoft stores opened, Windows 7 was also released, with ease-of-use features and performance enhancements, rather than an extensive reworking of Windows. As the smartphone industry boomed in 2007, Microsoft had struggled to keep up with its rivals Apple and Google in providing a modern smartphone operating system. But, in 2010, they found themselves working with companies like Nokia to instill their new Windows OS and provide top-notch user experience, 2011 to 2014. Following their success in smartphones, Microsoft proceeded to rebrand their softwares and announced Windows 8 in 2011, an operating system designed to run on PC and tablet alike. The following year, they launched Windows Server 2012 and Outlook, an email service to compete with Gmail. In 2013, Microsoft released the Xbox One with Kinect, a motion-sensing device made by Microsoft and designed as a video game controller. Some of its functions include an ultra-wide 1080p camera that could function in the dark due to an infrared sensor, high-end processing power and new software, the ability to distinguish between fine movements, such as a thumb movements, and determining a user's heart rate by looking at their face. Cool, right? Like any maturing business, Microsoft announced in 2013 that it was reorganizing itself into four business divisions: operating system, apps, cloud, and devices. On September 3, 2013, Microsoft agreed to buy Nokia's mobile unit for $7 billion, 2014 till present. In February 2014, Steve Ballmer stepped down as CEO of Microsoft and was succeeded by Satya Nadella, who previously led Microsoft's cloud and enterprise division. On the same day, John W. Thompson took on the role of chairman, in place of Bill Gates, who continued to take part as a technology advisor. In the same year, Microsoft acquired Nokia Devices and Services for $7.2 billion. It also acquired a game development company, Bajang, and a security company, Hexadite, for $2.5 million and $100 million, respectively. 2015 and 2016 were quite the productive years for Microsoft. They released their first interactive whiteboard and Windows 10. It was in the same year they became the third largest maker of mobile phones. In 2016, Microsoft announced the merger of its PC and Xbox divisions, announcing that Universal Windows Platform, UWP, apps would be the focus for Microsoft's gaming in the future. In June 2016, Microsoft announced a project named Microsoft Azure Information Protection. It aims to help enterprises protect their data as it moves between servers and devices. In November 2016, Microsoft joined the Linux Foundation as a Platinum member during Microsoft's Connect developer event in New York. In 2018, Microsoft announced the acquisition of GitHub and released various patches for the Windows 10 OS. This caused problems for their Azure space at first, but were finally resolved. In August that year, the company partnered with Toyota Tsusho to create fish farming tools using Microsoft Azure for Internet of Things, IoT. What made Microsoft so successful? There are tons of things that put Microsoft where they are today, but one of the most prominent, I'd say, is foresight. Bill Gates and Paul Allen knew that if computers were to come into play, they would need software. Gates and Allen built an interpreter for the basic language that could run on the Altair and sold it to the computer's manufacturer Instrumentation and Telemetry Systems, MITS. Over the years, Microsoft has emerged one of the big five in the tech industry and is currently the most valued tech company at almost $2 trillion. This is despite closing most of their stores during the COVID-19 pandemic. Suffice to say, Microsoft is on a roll and isn't going down anytime soon. Thanks for watching.
Thank you for taking out time to get useful tips to better your life. Do like and subscribe to this channel to stay updated on daily nuggets.